I'm getting decent frames. This ENB I'm using is... it's not slow at all in my game. Actually, I take it back. When I do turn around, the camera's facing the other direction.
Need something?
Anyone Where behind me usually...
climb and back, and we'll be off.
Well, I take it back. It is fast. It is a fast ENB. It's just a matter of... my hard drive's the bottleneck in my game. Because if it needs a skin texture for one of the females, it has to, it has to load the texture from the hard drive. If it's not already in the cache. If it's in the cache, then it's instant. But if I run Skyrim for, a few minutes, by then all the files I need are cached, then everything's smooth. But see, like, when I turn around to look in a different direction, it's spawning somebody. It's checking their textures. Everything. It's loading textures for the door, for the rift in trees, the path I'm walking on.
Come see me in the market if you're looking for the finest
sound effects of people's footsteps.
The ivory from this tusk will be perfect for the inlay on my amulets.
Loading Argonian skin if there's no Argonians yet in the game.
I think I have enough here to get started.
I mean, he might be the first Argonian that showed up.
Give you this.
Since I started up the game.
For all your trouble. Safe travels, Landstrider.
So the next Argonian I find, the skin will already be cached. See, now it's kind of... yeah, it is herky-jerky. I come in here, it's a little herky-jerky, it's loading up. First it loaded up the girl, then it loaded up Velia, then it loaded up whoever's behind Velia. Is that Lydia? Yeah. But once they get loaded, then everything's fine. It all gets cached into the system. Windows 10. Back in the day, they were called
at my armor stand in the market.
Swap files.
I told you not to ask any questions. Here's your reward, as promised.
Back in the Windows 3.1 era, you had the swap file. You can resize how big you want the swap file on your hard drive.
Hello, friend.
That's basically where your cache information was stored.
Mm-hmm. Need something?
I was just seeing what all she says.
I'll teach you how to use it effectively and keep you quick on your feet.
When you click on her. She's supposed to be asleep. There's a mod that makes NPCs talk as though they want to sleep.
Travel safe.
But I don't have that mod, so when I click on a sleeping NPC,
I need someone to deliver a message.
they talk like they weren't even asleep.
Ah, well, I recently approached Sibby Blackbriar about buying Frost, one of the finest breeding horses in Skyrim. He agreed to
sell. I should probably track down that mod, though, because it would make sense that when you wake up somebody, they'll be like, what do you want?
Sibby believes this exempts him from our deal.
And then they would roll back over and go back to sleep. I want you to talk to Sibby every time you click on
Then I want you to bring me Frost and the lineage.
Need something? And then they go back to sleep.
Good man.
And each race would have their own little thing that they said.
Head to the Rift and jail and talk to
and you can't, get him to tell you where unless they're like an important NPC,
bring them to me outside Riften.
You'll be you well can't interact with them while they're asleep. You have to wait till they're awake. And then you get I'll full dialogue options from them.
Go on then. I'm not exactly...
I can't remember what mod that is. I should probably look for it though.
Definitely not when associates of mine have been locked up. No, I'll meet you outside of town.
Now, in a vanilla game, that guy will stand in the corner at the Bee and Barb forever. Until you do his quest. And I didn't know that immersive citizen AI overhaul sends him over to the bunkhouse, which is kind of cool.
Aunt Helga, why demean yourself with these people you barely know? They show no real love for you.
It's only a bit of fun. You're a lovely young thing. You should try it sometime.
No.
So there's still some pausing going on. Uh-oh. That one woman over at Iverstead, she suffers from this issue as well. That Timber strong arm or whatever
her
name is.
Working at the Rift and Fishery is tough, but it puts some coin in my pocket.
She'll start chopping logs out in the front door, out on the front porch of the Iverstead Inn. Anyway, this guy he'll start chopping logs in front of the bunkhouse. I wonder if there's a fix for that. Maybe there is. Maybe you sleep fixes it, but I'm unfixing it because I have mods overriding you sleep sometimes.
Beautiful baubles and gleaming gemstones over here.
I'm hearing a dragon. I thought I saw a dragon from here too. That's kind of scary. Maybe it will show up in the video. I can't tell from this thumbnail. That's scary to see a dragon flying around while you're inside of a hold like
you're
that.
You're not supposed to be down here. Official business only.
So I haven't even been?
My mistake, then. Sorry, you can go on ahead.
So I haven't even been in this prison yet? I thought I've talked to Sibby before, maybe not. So this would be my first time even encountering the dude.
Watch what you're doing.
I think it's like a ladle on the floor that you always step on or walk over. So you get a comment from everybody. Am I being observed? Yes.
Have you come to gawk at me, or is this a social call?
Ah, let me guess. He wants his horse. Well, that's gonna be a bit of a problem. See, I don't really outright own Frost. That is correct. You see, Frost belongs to the Blackbriar estate. Technically, everything in the estate is owned by my mother, Maven. My plan was to take the horse from our lodge and deliver it to Latrush at the stables. Obviously, that didn't exactly work out as I'd planned. Still, I don't want to cross Latrush. Tell you what, steal the horse and deliver it, and you can have the second half of the payment. Sure, take advantage of the guy in jail. Okay, fine, I can make the deal sweeter. I obviously don't have anything here, but there's a hidden stash in the lodge. And I did manage to hold on to the key. Take it.
I couldn't remember how to get out of this prison. Okay. I was having all kinds of issues trying
I'm
to frap
so
this scene.
We're traveling to Eldegrin Sanctuary together. I
was only getting one or two frames per second when I was trying to record this whole thing. So so unfortunately I couldn't record any of the killing sprees we did with mercenaries out here in the front yard and the backyard. I thought... I think I do have some recordings of what happened. We'll see. They're gonna be choppy at best. Because a lot of the stuff here just wasn't recordable. The minute I turn on Fraps, I get down to like two or three frames per second. So some script was trying to run like crazy, spamming the hell out of this area. The nav mesh, I remember the nav mesh being horrific out here. And then the whole thing with LaCrush, look, wherever his name is. That guy, he's totally scripted. Usually my Skyrim will crash if I even try to go off the cliff behind this house. My followers have no idea how to follow me when I do that. Skyrim just decides to take a dirt nap.
Is someone there?
Is someone there?
So let's see if I remember if this was choppy or not. Yeah, it is kind of choppy. What are you doing? Phillies off.
Found you.
Too much script lag.
You're as good as dead.
Who's fighting who? Where?
You are my own head. Stop.
You can't see anything.
You're routed. Fall back. No.
Back of the brain. What's that? They all came running to us. We didn't have to even. We're still standing on the welcome mat. Is that basically what's going on here? Usually you have to go search for these guys. But no, they. Uh-oh. I don't remember if I took the key already from these guys. Okay, Lydia's with us now. Good. These mercenaries all seem to be clones of each other. They have identical inventories. Sort of a shame. You would think there'd be more variety. Maybe there's a mod that makes Maven's mercenaries diversified. Or immersified is probably the proper term. Speaking of immersive, I need to find myself some real food. I'm starving to death. May have to order some pizza or spaghetti or something. At work, I don't know if I mentioned this in a previous video, but at work, someone had challenged me to, make Pop-Tarts from scratch using a rice cooker. And I'm like, oh, challenge accepted.
Still here.
So now I have to remember to watch YouTube videos to see how people are making Pop-Tarts from scratch using their rice cookers. It's like I bought a rice cooker and I've made some rice. Yeah, but I've been making everything but rice with my rice cooker. Such is the life of a sheltered child. Anyway. Oh, I forgot there's usually a crazy person out here when you come out of this door. They spawn automatically. Because you think, oh, I killed everybody. But no, you come out in the backyard. Frame rate drops below zero. And you, some guy saying, I'm gonna kill you. Yeah, see, my frame rate drops, so I had to kill that guy or do something to get the frame rate back to normal, because he's like inside the ground or he's in a tree or in a rock. He's not spawning where he should be, so the nav mesh is all screwed up. So annoying. Oh, there he is. Did I kill him? Okay. And then I jump down this way, and there's no nav mesh, so. Like, I'm always asking to crash my game. So now my companions have to figure out how to get over here from where we just were. So I figured I'd save them the effort and just come inside the house, and they should just spawn here. So I'm all suited up to kill, just in case there's another mercenary dude that we missed the first time coming in here, but I don't hear any screaming and yelling from anyone. I was looking for, I guess, a hiding place of money. I wasn't paying to what Sibby said, where it is exactly. I'm supposed to be able to get half the payment for the horse, and then on top of that, I'm supposed to get... What am I supposed to get? Some other stash? Yeah, I guess this is the stash. Yep, I'm supposed to steal from it. So that's what Sibby, or not steal, but just take. Sibby gave me the key to it, so... And it's not there unless Sibby actually mentions something about it. Otherwise, you come in here and there's nothing on that spot. But I was curious now, how did I get the other half, the payment for Frost? Maybe an honest soul will hand it to me and say, oh, you helped so-and-so get Frost? Well, this is the other half you were owed, and then, you know. Like the courier, you know, he should show up and give me half of what? You know, half of the price for Frost or something like that. I don't remember. I was too busy fighting frame rate issues out here. Now this is weird. I have a key. I have all these keys to this place, yet that one door is still asking me to pick it. Pick the lock. See, I'm getting like one frame rate for some reason. Some script is trying to update or do something. It's making it impossible to frap this part of the quest. the horse is acting like it would rather be somewhere else instead of scripted to just stand here. It has places to go, people to see. Anyway, it's a short trip. I just have to go down and around to drop Frost off to that guy who's busy fighting tarantulas or wolves or something. Anyway, he's down here. What's his name? LaRouche? Anyway, he's down here somewhere. Who's fighting who now? Did I just run past a bear? Julia's not helping at all. I don't know what the deal is there. She might be broken. She's in the middle of talking about... Oh, now we're back to the one frame rate again. This guy is screwing up my Skyrim. This happens every time I do his quest. The frame rate just refuses to work when I even get near him.
Ha! You've done it! Got to admit, I wasn't sure you could pull it off, but you've definitely earned your pay.
Okay, the frame rate.
Here it is. I think I'd best be off now.
Let's see. I can't read that. I guess I got some gold from him. Yeah, the frame rate is just horrible. I can't even move. This sucks. So I thought if I killed this bear, I might get some frame rate back. I mean, it helps a little. One less critter. Oh, another one. That was pitiful lag right there. Okay, and then I panicked. I see this horse here, and I'm like, why is Frost still here? And then I realize, oh, that's Philia's horse. And then I thought, oh, is Philia broken? Because she breaks after she rides her horse. And she looks like she's okay, except for her invisible weapon she's got equipped. So at this point, it's time to see if I can crash my Skyrim. And where'd that guy go? He got on Frost and walked off or something? I don't know, my back was turned, so... I don't remember where he goes to, if he just spawns away, or if he actually goes somewhere after that quest. He's usually right about here. He must have hightailed it out of Dodge.
Makes this smell.
Okay, so we're still back to one FPS. Sort of a pain in the ass. Maybe if I just leave that area where that quest takes place, my frame rate will go back to normal. That's the plan, at least. Oh. So where to now? So I'm just going to end this video here because of the frame rate drops.